Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video I'm gonna show you how to make this Xbox controller effective in HTML and CSS. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started with it. So first thing first, we will make a new folder on our desktop that is gaming, and let me open the Photoshop project which I edited. So let it open. Wait a minute, and here we go. Here are the images. Let me show you them sequence wise how I edited them. So let me hide these layers. So the image which I downloaded was this. I made each and every part transparent and I have added them into different layers. It took me a lot of time. The video will get longer, so I just skip this part. If you want to, let me know in the comment section below. So these are the different layers. It took me around some hours, so I'm gonna skip this part. I'm gonna provide the link in description. You can download the images for free, and if you don't know how to download the project source code, you can watch the video I uploaded just yesterday, so and download it from there. These are the images. I will show it each and every images. So as for this, so let's cancel it out, refresh, and let's open our Atom text editor. Now let's add the gaming project folder here. Add to this window and discard state. We'll make a new file that is index.html, and let's make a new folder that is CSS. Inside that, let's make styles.css file. Now let's go to index.html. Now let's open our browser. Okay, wait a minute, let's cut this out from here and we'll paste it here. So let's open our browser, which is Chromium, and search for Bootstrap. Okay, wait a minute, we don't need Bootstrap here, we will just use this normal HTML body. So let's link our CSS file to it, that is CSS, styles.css. Alright, and let's go into our body section. Let's make a new section which has class header section. Okay, inside that we'll add an image which is image/image1.png, which has class bg1, which is background one. Let me copy this out. Okay, and we'll paste it for n number of times. Let's make a new div which has class background-image. Let's copy all this out and we'll paste it inside that. Let me show you each and every image. Image1 which is class bg1, image4 which is the left button, image5 will be the right button, and image6 will be the square type of button, and image7 will be the inner part of the controller. We have this at image8. Image9 will be some part of it which will be hidden. Image10 will be the circular part. Image 11 will be a button which has B label on it. Image 12 will be the last part which will have the least Z index. So let's go into CSS and we'll add body tag. Overflow X will be hidden. So, okay. Background color will be, let's add blue color. Hashtag 1196B4, which is a shade of blue color. Now let's access the header section. Dot header section curly braces, and height will be 100 view height, width will be 100 view width. Okay, and position will be absolute. From top it will be minus 40 pixel. We'll take it bit above, so from right it will be 300 pixels. So let's access BG1, which is background one, and the height will be 100 view height. Position will be absolute. From top it will be 0, from right it will be 0 pixels, and transition will be 1 second. It will have the fastest transition because it's the upper part of the controller. So let's paste it for each class, and we'll rename this classes, make it background 4, and also change the transition to 3 seconds, background 5, transition 3 seconds, 6, 3, 7, 3, 8, transition 3 seconds, and 9 will be, let's skip it, 3 seconds 2, background 10 also be 3 seconds, background 11 will be also 3 seconds, and background 12 will be also 3 seconds. Okay, so here we have done adding all our images, and we are done with styling them. So let's add Z index to it. Z index of the top part will be 15. So when the border is hovered, BG7, which is background 7, position will be absolute. From top it will be 220 pixels. So I am just positioning each and every element when they are hovered. So let's copy it out and paste it for background 8. Let's decrease the Z index, that is Z index will be 2. This will make this web design using different Z indexes, and we'll translate it by 90 pixels. So background 7 is the inner part, which is the middle part. This is to the middle part, but will be below that, so it will be Z index will be 2. So let's copy this out, we'll make it background 9, and we'll do this minus 150 pixels and background image. So let's do this background 10. We'll translate it in 3D, that as 108 pixels minus 117 pixels, 0 and the Z axis, and Z index will be 4. So let's copy this BG7 from here and we'll paste it here for background 1. From top it will be 410 pixels, from right it will be minus 4, and Z index will be 5. Okay, we'll transform it, we'll scale it, we'll make the size of this the biggest, because we'll hide all these parts below this. So let's make this BG4 by copy and paste it and remove all this, and we'll transform it. We'll translate 3D, 75 pixels, 85 pixels, 0. Okay. So let's copy all this out and let me show you which image I'm using. And now let's do this BG5. And we'll make it minus 110 pixels and 120 pixels for background 5. So let's make it background 6, and the background 5 will have Z index 6, and the background 4 will have Z index 6 too. Okay, and background 6 will also have Z index 6. These are on the same layers, so 116 pixels on X and minus 12 on Y. Square button here. So let's paste it for one more time. We'll make it BG11. We'll make it minus 133 pixels and minus 10 pixels, and Z index will be 6. So what I'm gonna say is, you can download all those images and project source code from the link I mentioned in description. And if you don't know how to download my project source code, I made a video for that, and I provided the link and the description for that too. So watch that video and download my project source code and enjoy your life. So let's copy the full path from here. Okay, and let's paste it in our browser. Control V and hit enter. Okay, so here we are, we got this effect, amazing effect. So like, share and subscribe my channel for more awesome videos. Thank you guys.